गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय क्लास। आई होप यू हैव स्टडीड ऑल माय लेक्चर्स केयरफुली। ओके, सो टुडे आई विल डू द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर थर्ड, पेयर ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशंस इन टू वेरिएबल्स व्हिच आर वर्ड प्रॉब्लम्स। एक्चुअली व्हाट आर वर्ड प्रॉब्लम्स? इन व्हिच अ सिचुएशन अ प्रॉब्लम इज गिवन टू अस इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ए लैंग्वेज, वी हैव टू मेक द इक्वेशंस आवरसेल्फ and then we solve those equations by any method. Okay, generally students, in the word problems we solve the equations by the elimination method because it is the easiest method. So today I am taking some of the word problems of our NCERT book, in which our first question is the difference between two numbers is 26 and one number is three times the other. We have to find the two numbers. Students, look at this. It is difference. In the case of difference, students, if you take one number as x and second number as y, the most important thing is that in the difference, you have to mention that which is the larger number, because we write the larger number first. Okay? So suppose the solution of first word problem, the difference between two numbers. So students, suppose let first number is x, in bracket we will mention it is larger. We can take y as also larger. So I am taking x as larger. So what is our second number? It is suppose y. So we have to make the equations using the statement given to us. The statement is the difference between two numbers. So students, we have take x as larger, so I have to write x first. X minus y is 26. Suppose students, if I have taken y as a larger number, then my equation will be y minus x. Okay, so this is my first equation. Now what is more given to us? It is and one number is three times the other. The second condition is one number is three times the other. Okay students, one is x and one is y, so it is already larger number. So to make them equal, we have to multiply the smaller number by three. Suppose student, one is six and on other side we have two. So we have two methods, either divide 6 by 3, okay, then 6 by 3 is 2, or if you want to make them equal, then multiply the smaller number by 3 to make them equal. So it is already larger number, so we are multiplying the smaller number by 3. When I take 3y on this side, my equation is this. So these are my two equations. Now I am solving these two equations, students, by the elimination method. First equation is this and second equation is this. So if we want to cut the variable x, so subtract this equation from this, so change the sign. X cancels with x. Plus minus is minus, so y minus plus 3y is 2y. And 26 minus 0 is 26. So what is the value of y? It is 26 upon 2, which is 13. So by putting the value of y in any of the equation, I am putting this value in equation 1. Okay. So what is x? It is 26 plus 13, which is 39. So students, our numbers are 39 and 13. So can you see that we have taken x as a larger number? Its value is 39 and y is 13. 13 3 ja 39. It means our condition is true, that one number is thrice of the other number. Okay students, now I am taking the second word problem. So what is the second word problem, students? The larger of two supplementary angles. Can you remember what is supplementary angle? Supplementary angles are a pair of angles whose sum is 180 degree. Pair means two angles. And what are complementary angles? Complementary angles are a pair of angles in which sum is 90 degree. So, supplementary angles, okay? So, in place of number, I will write, like, first angle is X. Okay? Larger. So, in this also, I have to mention which is larger. So, first angle is X and second angle is Y. Okay? Supplementary means that their sum is 180 degree. I have told you that supplementary angles are a pair of angles whose sum is 180 degree, and complementary angle are those angles whose sum is 90 degree. Do you remember? What are the two angles which are equal to their complement? Yes, they are 45, because 45 plus 45 is 90. And the two angles who are equal and they are supplement, they are 90 degree, because 90 plus 90 is 180. Okay. Now we have to make the second equation. The larger of two supplementary angles. So, which is the larger angle? It is X. It exceeds. Exceeds means increase. It's more. Exceeds the smaller. What is the smaller angle? It is Y. Exceeds the smaller by 18. So, students, same condition is applied here also. It is the larger number. It is greater than this number by 18 degrees. So, either subtract 18 from here or add 18 on this side. Because if I want that 5 should be equal to 3, then either subtract 2 from this side to make them equal, or add 2 on the least side to make them equal. Okay, students? So, what is our second equation? It is X minus Y is 18. It is our second equation. So, our first equation is, students, X plus Y is 180 and X minus Y is 18. So, can you see that? They are having the opposite sign. So, no need to subtract the equations. They cut variable Y directly. So, X plus X is 2x and 180 plus 18 is 198. So, what is x? It is 2 9 18. So, x is 99 degree. So, our first angle is 99 degree. And what is y? Put the value of x in any of the equations. Suppose in the first one, then it is 99 plus y. So, what is y? It is 180 minus 99 degree. Okay. 10 minus 9 is 1 and it is 81. So, y is 81 degree. So, students, can you see that the larger number is 99 and the smaller number is 81. So, now, students, my next word problem is of fraction. Okay, students. So, these types of word problems are also very important regarding the board exams. Okay. So, what is a fraction? Fraction is numerator upon denominator. So, how can we take the fraction? We can take fraction in the form of x upon y, where x represents numerator and y represents denominator. Okay. So, let's start the solution of this question. So, let fraction is x upon y. Okay, students, where x represents numerator and y represents denominator. So, now we have to make the equations using the conditions which are given to us. So, what is given to us? What is the first condition which is given to us? It is a fraction becomes 9 upon 11. If 2 is added to both the numerator and the denominator. We are adding 2 to the numerator as well as to the denominator. So, our numerator is x. We are adding 2 and in the denominator also we are adding 2. Now, the fraction is 9 upon 11. So, we have to make one equation using this condition. So, when I cross multiply it, 11 gets multiplied by x plus 2. So it is 11x plus 22. And we have to multiply 9 by y plus 2. So it is 9y plus 18. When 9y comes on this side, it becomes minus. And 18 minus 22 is minus 4. So our first equation is 11x minus 9y is minus 4. This is our first equation. But we have to solve two unknown variables. So we want one more equation. Okay. So next, what is given to us? It is given to us if 3 is added to both the numerator and the denominator. Now we are adding 3 with numerator also and with denominator also. Now the fraction is 5 upon 6. So make one equation from this condition. Multiply 6. It is 6 by x plus 3. It is 6x plus 18. And it is 5y plus 15. Okay. When I take 5y on this side, it is 6x minus 5y. And it is 15 minus 18, which is minus 3. So second equation is 6x minus 5y is minus 3. Now students, have you remembered the elimination method? We have to multiply this equation by 6 and this equation by 11. We have to interchange the coefficients. Okay. So when I multiply equation 1 by 6, we have to multiply whole first equation by 6 and whole second equation by 11. 11 6 66x minus 54y is minus 24 and 66x minus 55y is minus 33. So we have to subtract these equations so that 66x cancels with 66. Plus minus is minus. 55 minus 54 is y. No need to write 1. And plus minus is again minus. So 33 minus 24 is 9. Now we have to find the value of x. So it is 11x minus 9y. 9 into 9 is minus 4. So minus 81. So what is 11x students? It is minus 4 plus 81. Okay. So it is 77. So what is x? It is 77 upon 11, which is 7. So value of x is 7 and the value of y is 9. So our fraction is, students, it is x upon y. So it is 7 upon 9. Is that clear, students? Okay, students. My next word problem is of age. These types of word problems are also very important. So, do you know what is the meaning of hence and what is the meaning of ago? Hence, later, after means after 5 years. Okay. And ago means before. So, for after 5 years, we have to add 5. Okay. Suppose now my age is 30 years. So, after 5 years, my age will be 35. We have to add 5 and 5 years ago. So, what is my age before 5 years? So it is 30 minus 5. Okay. So one thing which you have to remember is that hence means after and ago means before. Okay. So let Jacob's present age is X years. And father's present age is Jacob is father, okay? And son's present age is Y years. Because we have to find their present ages. We have to find the present age of Jacob and his son. So, like Jacob's present age is X years and son's present age is Y years, okay? 5 years hence. 5 years hence means after 5 years. After 5 years, what is the age of Jacob? It is x plus 5. And what is the age of son? It is y plus 5. Now the condition is given to us. that 5 years hence the age of Jacob will be 3 times that of his son. This is the age of Jacob. This is the age of son. Jacob is 3 times. So Jacob is already 3 times. So to make them equal, we have to multiply the son's age by 3. Okay. This concept is clear, students. Some of the students do the common mistake that they add 3 in this. Okay. So that is incorrect. Suppose father's age is 10. Okay. If you add 3, is it possible? That's if son's age is 7 and if you add 3, then father's age is 10. Father is 3 times 7 into 3. Okay, students. So don't do this error. Times means you have to multiply that value. So now solve this equation to make it is 3y plus 15. When this 3y comes on this side, it is minus and 15 minus 5 is 10. So our first equation is, students, x minus 3y is 10. This is the first condition and we have made one equation using this condition. Now, what is the second condition? 5 years ago. 5 years ago. 5 years ago, the age of Jacob should be x minus 5 and the age of son should be y minus 5. Now, 5 years ago, Jacob is 7 times the age of his son. So, we have to multiply the son's age by 7 to make them equal. We have to multiply the smaller number by 7 to make them equal. Now, solve this equation. It is 7y minus 35. And this 7y comes on this side, it becomes minus. And minus 35 plus 5 is minus 30. So, second equation is x minus 7y is minus 30. Now, students, we have two conditions. By using those two conditions, we have formed our two equations. And now it is very easy to solve them to find the value of x and y. X is the present age of Jacob and y is the present age of his son. So, we have to subtract these equations. So that variable x cancels with x. Minus plus minus. 7 minus 3 is 4y and 10 plus 30 is 40. So what is y? It is 10. So the value of y is 10. So we can put this value of y in any of our equations. Suppose I am putting this value in my first equation. Then x minus 3y is 10 and the value of y is 10. So what is x minus 30? It is 10. So x is 40. So students, what is the present age of Jacob? Because we have taken the present age of Jacob as x. So it is 40 years and son's present age is 10 years. Suppose I want to verify our answer. Okay. Jacob's present age is 40 years and son's present age is 10 years. Suppose I want to verify my answer. Okay. 5 years hence. After 5 years, Jacob will be 45 and son will be 15 years. 15 threeja 45. It is 3 times. And 5 years ago, Jacob will be 35 and son will be 5 years and 5 7 ja 35. So we have verified both the conditions.